Hey everybody, I'm back to do a hair care routine video, and this was highly requested and I'm just getting around to doing it, so of course I am sorry as always. It took me some time to get this video done because I wanted to get into a hair routine that I was comfortable with and settled with before telling you guys about it. I've been switching around with a lot of products lately and I finally settled on something that I actually really like and probably will stick to for a while. Majority of the stuff that I'm talking about today I've mentioned before and probably will mention in my later videos, so sorry if I sound a little bit repetitive. Okay, starting off about my hair. My hair is naturally straight and it blow dries completely straight after I wash it, and it's a little bit bent up when I'm sleeping, and you guys have seen how my bedhead can vary. So I straighten in the morning, usually that's my typical hair routine. We'll have upcoming videos on how I curl my hair, how I wave my hair, and how I straighten my hair, and most should be up this week. So, of course, I have lots of heat damage because I like to use heat styling tools, which a lot of us do. Of course, we can try to minimize it, but if you want to use them, you're going to use them, so you have to repair your hair. Haircuts don't consist of being razor. They're more used with those shears with the jagged edges, so I guess that's not as damaging, or maybe as damaging. I'm not really sure. I'm not an expert in these things, but I do know because I like to thin down my hair that is extremely damaging. But it's just how I like to manage my hair because my hair can get a little thick towards the end. So my hair thins down towards the lower layers. And I have lots of layers. So I can imagine how damaging and crazy and choppy my hair probably is compared to just naturally being out and long and straight and all that. So I wash my hair every day. I already know that's really, really bad, and I know you guys are gonna yell at me about it and such and such. I know, it's bad. I heard that it's okay to wash your hair every day, as long as you're not experiencing excess fallout or any sort of dryness. And my hair doesn't experience any of that, so that's why I wash it every day. I wash it once a day at night. My hair is naturally super oily, and it can get oily even throughout the day, so I have to wash it at night. Especially, I don't like sleeping with the products in my hair because my skin is sensitive to hair products, and if I sleep with it, I'll wake up with acne face. So finally, moving on to products. As you guys may have heard from my May Favorites video, I've been using Joico's K-Pack Reconstruct Shampoo. And I also have the Reconstruct Conditioner. And it's for repair damage from coloring and drying and damaged hair. Perfect for me. Bigger than my head, like I stated. This is like the huge size. They have like normal sizes too. And they're having some sort of like package deal where you get like the shampoo and something, there's like three things for like $29. I paid like 40 something for both of these, but it was like a buy two, get two free deal. And I really like it. So luckily it was worth the money. It's really great because it has a pump. If you get the one with the pump or just add a pump onto it, it makes it more efficient. I think all shampoos should have pumps. It's just super easy. I see why salons have it. I love that stuff and I use it every day at night. I wet my hair, shampoo it all over, scrub really, really well, you know, make sure everything is completely drenched. I used about two pumps of each. And yeah, you can overdo shampoo and conditioner, but as long as it's still working for you, then that's fine. I also do the same with conditioner. I try to avoid my roots as much as possible because you don't need to condition your roots because the conditioner will weigh your roots down, and we don't like that. You're supposed to focus mostly on your ends. But because I have so many layers, I have very short layers too, so they need to get a little love. So I have to get up here. I try not to scrub it into my scalp, but I try to get my higher layers also because you gotta love everything. I not towel dry my hair, but I wrap my hair up in a towel and then I like do my face routine and I come back and like, you know, rinse or string out my hair so it's not dripping wet. And then I comb it and then I blow dry it. I cannot sleep without blow drying my hair. It's a pet peeve for me. Just because then my pillow smells crappy and I don't like that. So when I blow dry my hair, I use my Solano Top Power blow dryer. It's like a salon blow dryer. I love this thing. It's like simple settings and all, but it's super powerful. I dry my hair by flipping my hair over and drying it, because if you dry from the bottom up, you cut your drying time in half. And it really does work. It's hand comb through my hair as I dry it, flip it back over, make sure it's dry, brush it at the end, and then go on with my night. So aside from moving on to my simple hair routine, I'm gonna go into my favorite hair products. So everyone knows I love my Chi Silk Infusion, but I can't use that every day. That's kind of pricey, so I use my Tresemme Heat Tamer Spray, drugstore, super cheap, spray it all over and just like bam. All good. I section my hair and stuff, so I just get every section really good with that. New Joico product that I've also been using would be my Protect and Shine Serum. And this is like a heat protectant and a shining serum at the same time. Sometimes I use this like before waving my hair. I make sure I get my ends real good. This is like an oil consistency, so I try to use just a little bit. And it also has a pump. So I use basically like one pump maybe for half my head and another pump for maybe the top layers. And it really works. I like how shiny it makes my hair. I don't use it every day. I just use it whenever I feel like it. I'm kind of not consistent with my stuff. Another product that I use sometimes when I remember to before I blow dry my hair, not consistently again, would be my Joico K-Pack Split End Mender. And it is supposed to mend your split ends. And you put it into your ends before you dry your hair. And I do that, and my split ends have been looking better, so I can't say it doesn't work. But again, split ends cannot be permanently fixed. They can be mended together, but most likely they will split again. Best way to fix it is to cut it off. It's good to deep condition your hair. I mentioned it in my healthy hair care tips video, which I'll link right around here. Bam. To do that, I do love Lush's Swan Renoir hair treatment, but I don't use it consistently because it expires, and if I don't pay attention to it, then I just waste a lot of money. So you guys know I've picked up the argan oil treatment from Sally's. It was about $8, and there's a lot in it compared to like the stuff they sell at Sephora, which is like $35 and less product. And what you do with it is basically you put it in your hair, focus on your ends. You can wrap your hair into like a hot towel, and it will open like your hair up to absorb the oil in, and it treats your hair. It keeps it nice, soft, shiny, everything great about it. And I do love that stuff, so having some argan oil around, not a bad idea. Its smoothing balm is my generic smoothing balm from Sally's Beauty Supply that's comparable to Paul Mitchell's Super Skinny Relaxing Balm. I have so much left of it, it's like up here, and I use it for my flyaways, and when my hair just looks like it needs to be a little slicker. But I think my hair is starting to manage to slick itself down, because this is my hair with no product in it at all. So, I've mentioned a million times that my favorite teasing hairspray is the Bumble and Bumble Does It All styling spray. It's like a lightweight finish, so if you ever need something that you want to just comb through or use with heat, this is great. You can get it off of Amazon or salons or their website, which is bumbleandbumble.com. I paid for it. It's my second bottle. The only thing I hate about it is when you get a new bottle, it's really hard to press it down. Like, I have to, bam. My favorite finishing spray with a little bit more of a hold would be the Tresemme 24-hour finishing spray, and this is about down to here, second bottle. I use it a lot. I can use it right now. Bam, finished. That's pretty much what I do with it. I can use it for smoothing down my hair, and I'll like spray it and comb through it as it's still wet, and my hair will like stay smooth down. Let's say if I'm doing a poof or something, or if I want to do like a slick back look or updo or curls, I usually use that as my finishing spray. And I love the whole 24-hour body line, so I can definitely recommend that to you guys. At least would be my like hair clay waxes and pomades and such. My favorite is Sebastian's Crude Clay, and theirs is renamed to Craft Clay now, and you can get it off of Amazon or wherever they sell Sebastian products. And I haven't used the new one yet. I will try it eventually, but I do have a lot left of the craft clay right now. And I have a bobby pin in there because I use it to scoop it out. Because my nails cannot take clay in it. It's just, ooh. I just sound like I'm advertising a lot of brands. But to be honest, I really like their products. And usually if a company has some good products, I can't help but mention it. So that was my hair care routine. I hope you guys really enjoyed watching this video. I will have a giveaway video up soon, most likely this week, and I can't wait to share that with you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.